Interesting phrase, the kingdom of God. I want to talk to you this afternoon about developing a kingdom culture. Developing a kingdom culture. And it says in Luke chapter 11, verse 2, and he said unto them, when you pray, say, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come in earth as it is in heaven. Okay. What is that saying? You know, that phrase, the kingdom of God, is mentioned 69 times in the New Testament. Not the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God. 69 times. And it's like, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. In this earth first, as it is in heaven. You are the earth. It comes in this earth. And then it's manifest through you to the earth. Amen. Thy kingdom come in me and then be manifest in the earth. You see? Jesus is going to come in us before he comes for us. Amen. Really important to understand that. Transfiguration is going to become so common as the baptism in the Holy Spirit. Amen. That's the next phase he wants to take the church into. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, the culture of heaven is very different to the culture of earth. It's very, very different. Very, very different, in fact. It's, you know, and the more that you walk in the culture of heaven, the safer you will be in the days that lie ahead. Amen. You know, the Bible tells us in Isaiah 26 and verse 9, with my soul, I have desired you in the night, yes, but by my spirit within me, I will seek you early. By my spirit within me, I will seek you early. Then he went in and said, for when your judgments are in the earth, then the inhabitants of the world will learn righteousness. Amen. One of the things you have to understand about God is that God is good. That never changes. God is love and God is good, which simply means this: whatever God does or allows is out of this one motivation of love. He is not capable of operating outside of that. That's who he is. Not what he has, who he is. So whatever God allows, whatever great love for the people on this planet. But great judgments are coming because he loves people. And when these judgments are in the earth, the people will learn righteousness. God is really, really, really good. And we need to... That needs to be the anchor of our soul. You know, if you had a friend and God came to you and said, you know, she's a Christian, but she's going to backslide and go away from the Lord. And she's really going to miss out and go away from the Lord. And the Lord said to you, what shall we do? If we let, that's the track that she's on. What would you say? I know what I would say. Die, let her die and take a home loan. That's the most loving thing you can do than letting her live and end up in hell. Getting quiet in here. God is love. And everything he does is from that one motivation. That's got to be the anchor of our soul in these last days. If it's not the anchor of our soul, we are really going to be thrown. This verse also says, yes, with my spirit within me, I will seek you early. Essentially, you are a spirit. But that whole process has been reversed. And we've become very human and very physical, you know. But essentially, you are a spirit. Let me ask you a question. When was the last time you were aware of your spirit? Be honest. Getting real quiet now. That's who you really are. Come on, close your eyes. I want you to be you aware of your spirit. There's another person on the inside of you. It's like your avatar. It's on the inside of you. Be aware of him. Okay? Keep being aware of him. And let your spirit be enlarged. Enlarge your spirit. Come on, enlarge it. Do you see it enlarging? Enlarging till it becomes bigger than your physical body. You're supposed to be wearing your spirit. You see, that's you. That's your spirit. That's who you are. That's who you are. You know, in the Bible, you can look at me now. But be aware of that, all right? Your spirit. You know, the Bible talks about being enlarged in the Lord. What's he talking about? Be enlarged. He's talking about your spirit. Being enlarged. Your spirit is in connection with the Lord constantly. In your spirit, you know, is not subject to time. You know, one of the problems we have is people come along and said to me, well, where is it in the Word? I hate religious people, don't you? They really bug me. Some things are extra biblical, but they're not unbiblical. Amen. Understand where I'm coming from?
Amen.
They're not unbiblical, but they're extra-biblical. We've a lot still to learn about the Word of God, which we haven't learned yet. You know, when we teach somebody to prophesy, the Bible doesn't tell you how to prophesy, right? Not when the Bible tells you how you can prophesy, it just tells you you can do it. That's one thing, but how to do it is another. You have to be taught how to prophesy. That is extra-biblical. Many of the things we'll be sharing with you in this conference will be extra-biblical, but they will not be unbiblical.
Amen.
All right? And it's important you understand that. And oh, yeah. You are not of this world.
Hallelujah.
You know? That's got to become a reality to you. Let me tell you something. Only what you are aware of is real to you. Let me say that again. Only what you are aware of is real to you. This building is real to you because you're aware of it. If you close your eyes and visualize your home, the front door of your home, you're aware of it. It's real to you, right? Now, remember that. Remember, you are not of this world. You didn't come from here. You didn't come into existence at the point of conception. Right? Stay with me. You are very old. You've been around a long time before you came here. It was a privilege for you to come here. Your spirit. See, Ephesians 2:19, it says that, you know, now therefore you are no more strangers and foreigners, but citizens of the saints and of the household of God. You're now a citizen of the household of God. Think about that. You know, whether you're American, Chinese, English, French, and you know, there's some good things in all of our cultures. There's some bad things in them too. But you know, here today, we are not Chinese, we're not English, we're not Indian, we're citizens of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
That's the thing, we are citizens of the kingdom of God. We may have our own cultures. You know, I was walking in heaven once and I came across these people in heaven which were North American Indians. You know, and you go to heaven, you have a mansion, you know, I've got a mansion. You all right? These were teepees. Huge teepees made of gold and silver.